My name is Isaac Guenther, and I was born in Muncie, Indiana. Lived there for the first 6 months of my life, and then moved to the San Francisco Bay Area and spent my formative years in and around Santa Cruz, California, up until 1998. At the age of 26, I moved here to Central Florida and have been here ever since. My priorities at as a young man were drinking, drugs, and just having fun. I was really a ship without a rudder, honestly, in my teens and early 20s. I was a non-believer. I was actually an atheist. I was and am still an only child, but there was a dark side growing up in an alcoholic family. My mom was an alcoholic for the formative years of my life. I think my first recollection of her drinking to excess was probably around 7 or 8 years old. And her addiction just progressed, throughout my life. I think now she's been sober this time for about 7 years or so. Growing up in an alcoholic household, I remember being a little kid and, seeing the behavior that brought on and saying, oh, that's never gonna be me. And that's absolutely not true. But God had a path for me. And, I wouldn't change any of the things that I've done, but they allowed me to see how God worked in my life and have a much deeper and better understanding of His grace and how much I need His grace. I met Vanessa in the end of 1998 when I moved here for a job from California. I drummed up the courage to ask her out when I was doing the business's bank deposit, and she ended up not being my teller that day. Well, my cousin and I ended up going out on Christmas night. And who of all people in Orlando do I run into? Vanessa. So we had a great evening. We talked till late in the morning. She ended up reaching out to me a few days later and invited me to her family's New Year's Eve party. And we ended up getting married in September of 99. It's one of those things where when you know, it was quick, but 22 years later, here we are with three awesome girls. Her life changed me for the better. Because she started coming out to church, and at that point in time, this was 15-16 years ago, our marriage was in a very rocky place. I was actively drinking and using drugs, and she started coming out to church, and I actually gave her a really hard time for that. And then I started to see the changes in her character and was like, wow, my wife is really changing. There must be something to this. And that kind of, began the path of changing my life for the better. The most impactful turning point in my life was actually falling away from church for about 6 months and taking my family with me. I was actively drinking and using drugs and was blaming everybody else in my life, including the church, for my problems. And instead of making it about me and my issues of the heart and the demons that I carried around, I made it about everybody else. So I think my turning point was when I put myself in a situation where my life was truly at stake. My mortal life was and my soul were truly at stake, of imminent death. By the grace of God, I received medical attention and survived through it, and was given a choice by my wife to either get cleaned up and go back to God, or the alternative was to, lose my wife, lose my family, and probably end up, dead or in jail. Thing about addiction is it never goes away. Some days are easier than others. what's worked for me is in the beginning, you know, counseling and Narcotics Anonymous was instrumental. And now to this day, just being open and honest, not bottling up feelings, not making excuses, lots of prayer, and again, just honesty and confession. And you know, that starts at home with my wife, you know, being honest with her about my desires if they do come up. One thing I will say is that the more you rely on God and replace those things with Him, the easier it does become.